any inch of the real real. So stop it, I ain't knocking your look.
Only religion was the moolah. Made a couple million, hallelujah. Daddy was a tutor. Called a homeschooler. Never did homework. I was gone home with the work, no tutor. Used to have enough. Grew up with the hustlers and the killers. Now I'm kicking it with Puffy in the villa. Chillin', click full of zombies like Thriller. Got real, about to get real. That's just how I'm feeling.
I'm on one. My big box got me feeling so bossy. Like Lauren Hill, me I kill them softly. This a girl rather fi be called a naughty. Cause if my too loyal, then it's gon' cost me. And
that's just how I feel.
Yeah.
That's just how I'm feeling.
That's how I feel.
Dog, that's just how I'm feeling. When I touch down, I'ma burn it all to the ground.
Today, from Soldier Field in Chicago, it's week 6 of the NFL on EA Sports. Chicago Bears taking on the Pittsburgh Steelers.
They say summer is the time to live in Chicago. Well, that's extended into autumn as we are ready to roll under blue skies at Soldier Field. This was the scene a moment ago as the Bears emerge from their tunnel. Ready for football are they, and for football are we as the Bears get set to match up with the Pittsburgh Steelers? With Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gauden. And Charles, you look at this Bears team entering play. And they've lost three straight here, and it goes without saying, I guess, they could certainly use a win.
And how do they get a win? Because they've lost three straight, I think it's paramount that they get a fast, clean start to this game.
Meanwhile, for the visiting Steelers, they're off to a terrific start, unbeaten at 5-0 through the first month and change.
And you can hang a lot of this early success on their defense, too. They're the tone setters for these guys, and the entire team feeds off of what they do.
Set to go now in week 6 of the NFL season, and we are underway on EA Sports. And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. So here are the Bears now for their opening drive. They'll be led out by a first-round pick back in 2021 from Ohio State. It's Justin Fields.
Coming off of a loss their last time out, I think he's just seeking to make a bigger impact on the game. He threw a touchdown pass, didn't throw an interception. I think he just wants to jump those numbers up in terms of flinging it around and letting his receivers get into the end zone.
First down, Rose. He's got his tight end, Freiermuth, over the middle. And he's upended at the 33, following a good pickup of 8. These are his numbers from last week's contest. 6 catches, 69 yards.
And I'd certainly expect them to use him quite a bit because he runs excellent routes, has good hands, and knows how to get open.
So from the 36 now, first and 10.
Well, we always talk about good down and distance allowing offenses to expand their playbook. Well, second and 2, that means your playbook's wide open. You can run just about anything. But a lot of times, the play caller, he just looks down at his sheet, sees the short yardage runs, and goes to one of those.
Back to throw now on second and 10. And this throw incomplete. Well, the defender all over at that time, and it's going to lead to third down. To throw on third down, Rose. That ball caught by the former Toledo Rocket, Deontay Johnson.
Well, this is where reading defenses and practice time comes into play. You've got to know what you're running versus zone versus man and how to run the proper route. And they just executed that one pretty well.
Couple of first downs on the drive already as they'll go from the 47 now on first down. Again, he'll drop to throw. He'll find Juju Smith-Schuster. And forget about the run to set up the pass. They're just coming out throwing.
Forget trying to set anything up. They feel like they have the advantage. They feel like they have the matchups, and they're just attacking right now.
Yep, going to the air on the opening drive. And nothing doing. He's immediately taken down at the line of scrimmage. Trying to keep the drive going here. This is play number 7 on 3rd and 2. From the gun, this will be McFarlane. And he will have first down yardage as he's brought down at the 41.
You know, it was tough for them to stand on the sidelines and watch the other team take it downfield and score, wasn't it? So they knew when they got on the field, it's on them. Pick up first downs, get downfield and score. How about them picking up that 3rd and short?
I was just going to say, you and I were talking before the game, those 3rd down conversions are going to be huge in this one. Clock rolling as we hit the midway point of this first quarter. Throwing on first down. Pressure, and he's taken down. A Bear sack. They'll wind up losing 8 on the sack there, and it's 2nd down. found his way into the backfield, and he simply would not be denied.
Well, they say that life's all about opportunities, and that holds true when you're playing defense as well. How about him seeing that chance, making the most of it, did a great job of wrapping him up and bringing him down.
So that complicates things a bit here. 18 yards to go now on second down. Operating from the gun, Rose. That went into the hands of his tailback, Samuels. Give him a gain of 5 on the completion, and that'll make it 3rd and 13.
That might feel like a little bit of a lost opportunity there for the offense because the defense brought pressure that time. And sometimes against that, you can get out to your running back and it could turn into a big gain downfield. But what a nice job they did getting to him quickly and holding him to a short gain.
It's a game of matchups, and that's why you take your receivers and move them around a bunch, especially your best guys. And when they work out of the slot, you often hear the coaches talk about how great it is because it gives you a two-way go. You can break out or you can break in. That makes it hard to defend.
First carry of the game for Jalen Samuels. Chris Barnes there on the stop. After the pickup of 5, here's 2nd and 5. Looking to throw. Rose. And that's complete to the right side. It's Marshall. Now a 1st and 10 at the 11. From the gun, Rose. He dumps this off underneath to McFarland. And he's able to work it here to the 8-yard line. They'll contain him to just 4. 2nd down. On the give, this is McFarland. And once again, he's going to be stopped up behind the line. 2nd straight play. Shades of the 85 Bear defense a little bit.
Have to give credit for a nice play there, but also have to look at it as a blown assignment. He became a free runner that turned into a free hitter.
The Bears bring out an extra defender in the secondary now for 3rd down. Back to throw, Rose. This will be caught at about the 5. Had a nice job to break free of one tackle, but it slowed his momentum somewhat, and he's taken down right after.
Receivers love having the reputation of being go-to guys on 3rd down, and he was fighting like he really wanted to have that reputation, didn't he? I mean, he came very close to making that a 1st down.
Broke the one tackle, but couldn't spring himself free. Now a field goal forthcoming for the Steelers. Flip it to the kicker. He looks like he's going to throw it. And how about this? It's complete. And in for the Steelers' touchdown. Pat Freiermuth. His 2nd touchdown on the season. And the Steelers are an extra point away from tying this thing up. It took a pretty big risk right there going for it on 4th down. But, hey, not only did they get the 1st down, forget about that. They got in the end zone.
Yeah, because normally you're just thinking, can pick up a 1st down? Instead, they go for the end zone and get it done with no margin for error. Remember, 4th down, they went for it.
Lux with the extra point. And that will tie our score here in this opening quarter of play. Team's had it. Each team has scored. 7-7 here as the kick's away. And it'll come out to the 25 as he will not attempt to return. Chicago works their way back onto the field here for their 2nd drive of the game. Good drive last time. Really effective passing the football. Do you maybe mix it up, now go to the ground game and surprise the defense a little bit?
I would anticipate the defense making some changes, but I wouldn't necessarily just absolutely go in the opposite direction. They're doing so well throwing the ball.
Yeah, why?
I wouldn't change it up until they showed me a reason to do so.
It's a 6-yard gain on the ground, and that'll make it 2nd and 4. Fields. He's going to loft one deep left side here. Oh, that's into double coverage and intercepted. Picked up by Minkah Fitzpatrick. And they will finally get him as he's all the way down near the 40-yard line. CD, he tried to kind of lob that one in there. It looked pretty going through the air. The problem was it was in the air a little bit too long.
Yeah, and that's a tough one because for that type of a route and what he tried to do and needed to do, he had to put a little air under it, and the defender was actually able to take advantage of it because it hung up there just long enough for him to get there and take it away.
On first and 10, Rose. And he'll go down. The Bears get there for the sack. It's Khalil Mack that time, shooting in there to get him to the ground. I think a lot of time when we see a sack, you say, well, you blame it on the offensive line, the quarterback, but here, maybe you just tip your hat to the defender. What a play.
Yeah, and I think sometimes they just get a sense of the play before the ball's even snapped, kind of like a sprinter anticipating the gun in a race. They're off, and guess what? The quarterback's down.
Second and 16. Looking to throw, Rose. Open man, that's the tight end, Freiermuth. And he is out of bounds, but not before he's inside the 30.
It's a nice zone breaker right there. Take the tight end, move him out to the slot, then have him run a corner route versus the zone coverage, which means he's going to be behind the shallow coverage and ahead of the deep coverage, put the ball right on him.
First down, Rose. Here's Freiermuth again. And inside the 20 before he's brought down.
When this offense can get their tight ends involved, they can move the football. Here, a nice route, able to look it in, and picks up the first down.
So the ball down to the 16 here for first and 10. From the red zone now, they'll look to throw. Quick hitter here, it's complete. And he'll be taken down at the 2-yard line. Now a play fake here on first down. Got his man, it's caught for a Steelers touchdown. Ian Thomas, his second touchdown on the season. And the Steelers are going to take the lead.
This is why a lot of play callers love play action in this spot. You just want to freeze the linebackers just for a second. Then you've got a chance to get a quick pass into your tight end right behind them for a touchdown.
Lutz will look to add the extra point. And he's got it. It's now a 14-7 ball game. Five plays there on that drive. And it ends with the Steelers finding the end zone. The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. From a couple yards deep, he'll bring it out of the end zone. And he'll get it up past the 20 to about the 22. Here's the Chicago offense coming back out onto the field. And following the interception, we'll see what they can put together on this drive.
I can hear my old college coach right now. He always used to tell us before every game, the team making the fewest mistakes will win. What they're hoping is that that last mistake is their only one of the game.
Coaches, that's all they talk about, turnovers, right?
Minimizing those and maximizing opportunities.
2 yards the loss, second and 12. This defense for the Steelers, they were very good in the victory a week ago over Cincinnati.
And as in any game, takeaways are always a big key. They're always discussed on defense. There's an emphasis there, and they came away with 3 interceptions in that game.
So the opening play of the drive goes backwards. Now they'll come up on second and 12. Fields now to throw. He'll get that complete to his tight end, Cole Kmet. A good gain of 9 before he's brought down at the 28. one quarter, 14-7, our score. From the gun, here's Fields. And a Steeler pressure too much here. He's going down. T.J. Watt with a big-time sack on third down. It's a loss of 7.
Now, that was just absolute perfect man coverage. Nowhere for them to go with the football led to a sack. And that's really difficult to do in today's NFL with all these gazelles running around that you're trying to cover in the secondary.
On fourth down, Matt Hawk to punt it away. He punted 4 times in the loss last week as he gets this one away here. That'll be a 49-yard punt, 6 yards there on the return. Here comes the field general leading his offense back out there for the next possession. He's got to be feeling pretty good, playing well. Team has the lead, so just looking to mount a drive here that ends in the end zone.
And all quarterbacks will tell you, hey, we love a running game, helps us out. But at the end of the day, they want to rely on their arm, throw the football, feel good about things, keep things moving in the right direction. Right now, that's exactly what we're seeing.
And we'll see if that continues.
That's a nice throw there, and he's obviously feeling pretty good because, remember, he had a touchdown pass on the last drive, and here he comes out throwing again, and they wind up getting good yardage and a first down right out of the gate.
On first down, McFarland, and he's going to be met at about the 43. To throw on second down, Rose, open man, completes it to Smith-Schuster, and he's dropped right at the 40, gain of 3. The Steelers on third down, they've been good, 3 for 4 thus far. This will be 3rd and 5. Eluding the pressure right, and he'll hit the deck, but he did not get there. He opted to go with a scramble, gets 2 yards, and now it's 4th. And he has got it from 55 yards away. That was never in doubt. So that one on target, and it adds to this first half lead.
And maybe we're too early to worry too much about 1-score lead, 2-score lead, etc. But this is where you kind of start banking those points that come in helpful later on.
And that decision to bring it out ends up not being a good one. Cost him about 5 yards as he's tackled at the 20. The Chicago offense set to get started. They trail by 10, 17-7 as they come up on a 1st and 10. Out of the gun, Fields. This one swung out to Montgomery. And he is brought down at the 22 after a gain of 2, and it brings up 2nd down. From the 22, here's 2nd and 8. A shotgun snap, Fields. And that falls to the ground, incomplete. A nice job of bodying him up defensively. And now it brings up 3rd down. Throwing on 3rd down, Fields. And he's going to get this one across the 30-yard line. So he turned to a trusted, familiar face in that 3rd down situation. It paid off.
Yeah, you go to your veteran receiver in that spot, so you can't underestimate him when he's on the field. Defensively, make sure you know where he is because he understands how to get open in key situations.
So they'll come up 1st and 10 now from the 33. Handoff comes to Montgomery. And he'll be limited to a short gain up to about the 34-yard line. Here's second and 9, just a yard on that last run. Here's Fields. They'll leave it for Montgomery, complete. And he'll be brought down shy of the 40 at the 38-yard line. The result, only 4 yards there on the play. And it'll be third down. To throw is Fields. Middle of the field, it's Robinson. And he's going to have a first down as he's brought down at the 44-yard line.
Well, they've certainly gotten him involved in this first half, and on third down, they looked his way again. And what a delight for his quarterback to find him and keep the drive moving.
A pair of first downs gives him a first and 10 up at the 44. Back to throw, Fields. Got a man, it's Berrios, complete. And he'll be corralled out across midfield down to the 45.
It's a nice completion, a little bit of run after catch as well to create the yardage that they got. But it is so tough to cover that route, the drag route, because they run it at varying speeds, because the key is to create hesitancy on the defender's part.
Always so empathetic for those DBs, aren't you? Second and 9 from the 44. Now it's Fields. Over the middle, he gets it to Berrios. And they're going to have themselves another first down as the tackle's made at the Steelers' 32-yard line. Now after the completion, we're going to get a timeout, an injured player. While the training staff works on him, we'll step aside and be right back. First down, Fields. He'll get that complete to his tight end, Kmet. He's tackled a yard short of the marker. Good gain of 9 on first down. Montgomery back to the ground. And he'll get him inside the 15 down to the 14-yard line.
This drive is turning into an extended one, and the guy carrying the ball, he's becoming more like a body blows guy. Every carry is putting some damage on the defense. So after a while, I'm not too sure how many guys are going to want to run up and tackle him.
Here's a first and 10 at the 14-yard line. From the red zone now, they'll look to throw. And he's got it! Touchdown, Bears! Braxton Berrios, his second touchdown on the season. And the Bears draw a bit closer. And on that one, able to catch it, also able to have the wherewithal to take it in for the score.
And how about the phases of a successful catch and a completion of a play? Look the ball in, secure the catch, and then, of course, the run after the catch that ends up in the end zone.
Elliott good with a PAT, and the lead is down to a field goal. That one in the books as a 12-play drive, and the end result is a Bears touchdown. For the touchdown, here's Elliott on to kick it away. From a yard or two deep, here comes a return. And they'll get him down right around the 25, actually the 26 officially, so a net gain of 1 there. And here comes a big tight end as he gets set for this next drive. And we roll the highlights, 5 catches. You know, schematically, what do you do to stop a tight end like him?
You have so many different options, whether you want to play 3-deep zone, 2-deep zone. One of the ones that I think works really well is what they call 2-man. 2 guys deep in on the half-field marks, usually the safeties, but you have someone underneath that plays man-to-man against the tight end. Keep him from finding those gaps and those holes where he can sit down, establish himself, and show himself to the quarterback and provide an easy target.
The previous run, good for 9. Here's second and a yard. Off play action. Rose. Flush to his right. And he'll get it out near the 40 to the 39. So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10. Operating from the gun, Rose. That is caught by Smith-Schuster. And he's brought down. So into Bear territory now. This is first and 10 at the 44-yard line. On the handoff, it's McFarland. Yeah, give him 4 yards there. It'll be second and 6. An inside handoff. This is McFarland. And this time not quite to the 30. It'll be down at the 31-yard line. A gain of 4 last play. They double that here and get 8.
So a nice run right there. And worth mentioning, their usual starting running back out this week. The hope is it's just a short-term absence. But this is where it pays, Charles, to have a quality reserve that you can turn to when you need him.
And to me, they definitely have that, because this is a guy who's more than capable of picking up the slack. And he's likely going to see a big share of carries as this one progresses. And how many times do we see running backs jump into the breach and have big games?
Nowhere to turn here, and he's going to go down. Back at about the 37-yard line. Khalil Mack able to get in there for his second sack of the afternoon. Sacks, a growing theme in this first half. This is second and long. Back to throw. Rose. That's complete to his tight end, Freiermuth. The Steelers on third down. They've converted 3 out of 5 thus far. This is 3rd and 7. And he'll just toss it away. So he throws it away, and that brings up 4th down. And Lutz puts this one through. And they stretch the lead to 6. It's 20-14 now. So the scoring drive encompasses 9 plays, and the net result, 3 points.
Take your disappointment and put it aside. 9 plays, yeah, they want to end up in the end zone with a touchdown. I get that. But sometimes those 9-play drives pay dividends later with another 9-play drive that culminates in a touchdown when they wear down a defense.
Here comes Justin Fields and the rest of the Bears offense. He's had a solid start to this game, but bottom line is they're losing, so he doesn't care about his stats. He just wants to right the ship on the scoreboard.
He wants to actually increase his stats because he feels like if he does, that means things will get better for his team, maybe get them back into the ball game or into the lead. In these situations, I remember playing with a quarterback once where he actually ran out onto the field first ahead of everyone else just to say, guys, let's go. Try and create that energy, create that spark.
Well, so far he has 1 touchdown, 1 interception. He'll be looking for that 2nd touchdown now.
A good run there off right tackle in an old school NFL football. The right side of the offensive line, often known as the nasty side. The left side, usually the technical side. Kind of reminds me of the old Atlanta Falcons 2009, 2010. That's how they constructed their offensive line.
Fields on 1st down. Open man is Komet, the tight end. And this will leave him 1 yard short. Nice pickup of 9 yards on 1st down. Here's 2nd and 1 yard. From the 50, here's Fields. Over the middle, complete. It's Robinson.
Many teams, as soon as they spot man defense, if they haven't called a hitch, they'll get to it as fast as they can. They want to put the ball in the hands of one of their best playmakers and hope that he can break a tackle on the outside and go for big yardage.
He'll lose a yard there, and it's second and 11.
As a linebacker, you're taught to stay just slightly behind the ball carrier just in case he makes a cutback. But when you find the gap, shoot it. And he found it all right, took it straight into the backfield, and made the tackle for a loss.
Second and 11. 2 minutes remaining in this first half of football. Coming up at halftime, I'll go from one personality, that's you, Charles Davis, to another one in Orlando, the coach. He'll have stats and scores from around the NFL. You and Jonathan Coachman, both larger than life.
No doubt about it.
But you're stuck with me in this booth,
yes,
and he's
I
miles
am.
Away and smiling.
And happy.
Now Fields completes a Mooney on the slant. And he will have the Bears first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
Third and four is always a tough call. Maybe a little too long to run for it, but not too long to hit him on the quick slant. And that was well executed. Found the window and zipped it right in there.
Now a first down throw, Fields. Throw to the right, taken in by Berrios. They'll contain him to just four, second down. And worth pointing out, after that last completion, that puts this young quarterback over 10,000 yards passing for his career. And fair to say, he's not done yet.
No doubt about it. He's really just getting started because he's not quite into the prime of his career. So it's likely he's going to hit a few more of these milestones as this career progresses. So let's face it, we'll acknowledge this number and we'll celebrate the milestones down the road.
Now the Bears going to call the first of their timeouts as the clock will stop with 55 seconds to go until halftime. Inside the red zone here, they'll look to throw. Touchdown! He scored on the ground and through the air. And the Bears can grab the lead with the extra point. These two teams in this first half, it's been fun. Back and forth, back and forth. Well, it's not fun for the defensive coordinators, but offensive coordinators are enjoying it.
Yeah, they're having streaks here, aren't they? Being able to put scores together and really bunch them up, and we have a tight game here. You know, we often talk about having the right shoes for the right turf. Today is track shoes, because that's what we've seen with these offenses.
Yeah, it's been an absolute track meet so far. Fun to watch. Elliott good on the extra point. Give him the lead here as we get on towards halftime. Now after the touchdown, here's Elliott on to kick it away. And this will not be brought out. It's a touchback. Here he is, the man taking the snaps under center, heading out for the next possession. Been a decent start for him here in this first half, but bottom line, his team's losing. They got to fix something.
And it starts with him. He has to keep that little quarterback strut going right now to make sure that his team sees him as confident. Continue to try and up his game, but just let them know, hey, if I'm around, if I'm the one calling signals and throwing the football, just follow me, we'll get there. Sometimes that will do more to elevate a team than anything else.
See if he has that confidence. Steps away to his left. And he slips up past the 45 before being tackled. Now the Steelers use the first of their three timeouts as they stop it here with just under 40 ticks to go in this first half. Throwing on first down, Rose. Throw left side, complete to Smith-Schuster. And he's able to take it across midfield before going out of bounds. 7 yards to pick up there. Looking to throw on second down. Rose, right side, Claypool's got it. Now the Steelers use the second of their three timeouts as they stop it with 28 seconds to go in the first half of play. From the 32 now, here's first and 10. From the gun, Rose. And he'll toss this one incomplete. Seeing no options, he throws it away.
So, Charles, you look at this offense, and really on paper, at least, a great situation for them upcoming. They're unbeaten on the year, an open week coming up after this. So I guess my question, any worry that maybe this is coming at the wrong time?
Oh, definitely I would be worried about this game, maybe more than any other on the schedule, because I know my guys are looking ahead to that open week. I've got to keep them focused on the task ahead, make sure they take care of business in this one. Otherwise, you're talking about a double trap. The trap of losing the game and then having the open week and having to stew about it.
Now the Steelers going to use their third and final timeout as they'll stop it with 13 seconds to play in half number one. The kick by Lutz is good. And with that, they'll take a two-point lead here in quarter number two. Now the drive ends in just three, but they'll take it. Looks like they'll head to the locker room, barring something unfortunate, in front on the scoreboard.
Yeah, they may not be jumping up and down and celebrating because they have the lead, but still, any little momentum in a game like this is important to a team, and they'll feel real good about going in and regrouping, knowing that they are out in front.
And with time running short here, they'll simply take a knee, and that should do it for half number one. So we've reached halftime in a wild first half. We'll take a minute to catch our breath as we'll send you down to Orlando and we check in with Jonathan Coachman for our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach.
All right, Brandon, thanks. A few teams starting to rise to the top as it's time to take you around the NFL here in week six. We'll begin our tour up at First Energy Stadium in Cleveland, where it was the Browns who were winners in that one at home. Taylor Heinicke, excellent in the victory, as his guys run their mark to 4-2 on the year. From there, let's head west to see what's going on with the Raiders at home in Las Vegas. And they have the lead in that one over the visiting Buffalo Bills. Derek Carr lighting it up, three touchdown passes there. Finally, let's get you to Baltimore, check on the Ravens at home at M&T Bank Stadium. And they were losers in that one to the visiting Cincinnati Bengals. Joe Burrow, a strong performance there, over 300 yards passing with three touchdowns in the victory. Meanwhile, in our game, no shortage of offense as each team has been able to move the ball effectively. Will the defenses show up in the second half? To find out, we give it back to our commentators, Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
Okay, Coach, thanks as always. This one's still anyone's game as we welcome you back for quarter number three. It's been a shootout so far. We'll see which defense can make the adjustments as we get back underway in the second half. And a good return as he'll be stopped just shy of the 30-yard line. So here are the Steelers to take over on offense. Remember, they're riding that five-game winning streak and right now in the driver's seat in this ball game as well. Man, I just love being in this stadium. So much history, tradition, so many great teams and games, and we're seeing a pretty good one right now, hotly contested in the third quarter. And seeing no options, he just tosses this one away incomplete. Now that'll bring up second down.
When defenses get to the quarterback that quickly, a lot of times it's called a jailbreak. It wasn't quite that fast, but fast enough that he had no time to look downfield and set himself to throw the ball. And as he tried to do that, he was hit and it forced an incompletion.
So now second and 10 after the incompletion on first down. Looking to throw. Rose. Now they set up a screen for McFarland. He's going to lose yards. They take him down at the 26.
Well, Brandon, we could see that play developing, and they were hoping that he was going to be able to put a move on the first guy and turn it into a big play. But no such luck. The speed on defense continues to get better and better in the NFL. Pretty nice example there of those guys being able to run from their assignments and finish off that play.
And this pass broken up. Excellent coverage there on third down, as that was not an easy one to hold on to. So no problems moving the ball in the first half, but they'll likely come up empty here on drive one of quarter three.
And it was so important for the defense to get that stop, because what we witnessed in the first half was them getting run over, and they needed the confidence, and they needed to get off the field so they felt good going forward in this game.
The Steelers send out their punter now, as he's on to punt for the first time this afternoon. Six yards on the boot. The coverage holds him to just three on the return. And the Bears take over. Now we take a glance at the offense as they work their way back out for their first possession of the second half. And both of these defenses have been stifling these last few drives offensively, just not able to get anything going. So what needs to change?
I think a lot of the guys will go back and review, so to speak, because everyone has someone assigned to how did each play work. Okay, what did we use that kind of worked for us during this game? Try and get back some of those plays, as well as the possibility of showing something you haven't shown already in this game and trying to change things up.
We'll see if they take the advice of Mr. Davis. The big play to start him out has him at the 45 already. First down, here's the run with Montgomery. And he'll be taken down across the 50 at the 45 in enemy territory. 47 yards rushing for him now in the ball game.
Well, they've certainly been successful throwing it around in this game, and that's allowed them to move the ball on offense. But I've got to tell you, to watch them run the football and successfully, I'm not taking sides. But to see the ball in the running back's hands, oh, that's football for me.
Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on first down. Here's Fields. Gonna let one fly for Robinson. Got a man, it's caught inside the 10. Now after the completion, we're gonna get a timeout, an injured player. While the trainers take a look, we'll step aside. The chain gang hustling to catch up. Here's first and goal from just inside the 10. Back to throw. Fields. Dancing. And he's going to have to eat this one as down he goes. It's a loss of four, and now it's second and goal.
Well, there's still time to rectify this situation, because the silver lining, they took a sack on first and goal. But that close to the goal line, it still definitely hurts.
They'll try again on second and goal after going backwards to the 12. Another try after the first down sack. Fields, the quick slant caught. A 10-yard completion, but still now facing third and goal. Montgomery. And they'll get him down just shy of the goal line at about the one. He needed three, he got two. Now that'll set up an interesting situation here on fourth and a yard.
That didn't just feel like good defense there, that felt like pride, didn't it? He's already gotten into the end zone twice, trying to get there for a third time. No one likes to have the hat trick against them.
Now we've got a field goal coming up here for Chicago. From the right hash at a bit of a tight angle. The kick by Elliott is good. And with that, they move ahead by a point here in this third quarter. So, CD, maybe put a pin in that one as this game progresses. It's a field goal that gets them the lead here in the third, but, boy, you hate settling for three when you're that close to the goal line.
Well, it certainly pains me to say it, but I do think it was the right call. Now, if they lose, you and I both know that'd be one of the things that gets second-guessed. Why didn't you go for it on fourth and goal? But I know the mindset was take the points, get the lead. And by the way, if they went for it and got stuff, they'd second-guess that too.
Yeah. The Steeler offense here about ready for their next drive. And a tight game after punting last time. See if they can get something going on this drive.
As they head to the field now, with the game this close, you've got to feel there's a sense of urgency for them going on offense right now. But they have to do it without letting panic creep in and affect their play.
And a quick throw here, that's complete. And he'll get it out near the 40 to the 39. On first down, McFarland. And he's going to get a solid gain of 9 before being brought down. Second and right at a yard.
Playing against a 3-4 front is really challenging for offensive linemen because they can do so many different things. But when you're running the football, if you can handle the nose tackle up front and it may be a guard can slide up to the second level and block a linebacker, that's when you have success running the football.
And he'll be brought down just shy of midfield at the 49-yard line. Two first downs have him up near midfield now on first and 10. Toss play for Samuels. Looking to find a lane, but he can't, reined in at the line of scrimmage. Officially nothing on that last run. They'll try again, second and 10. Now a run with McFarland. And he's got it across midfield and into Bear territory. They'll come up now on a second and long after the hold. Now they'll switch it up here and look to throw. He finds his man, Johnson. That's a gain of 11. Would have been a first down if not for that penalty moments ago. On third down, Rose. He's got a man. It's his tight end. That's complete. And he's going to have another first down as the tackle's made here at the Bears 30.
I know exactly what's going to be said about that play from the defensive perspective.
What's that?
That's why I tell all you guys we need more than one tackler to the ball. He broke the first tackle. Luckily enough, there were more people there to get him down.
So first and 10 now from the 30. On the ground, it's McFarland. And he'll maneuver his way forward for about 4. Second and 6.
When you find that kind of yardage, you couldn't be more confident as a ball carrier. And guess what? You're going to go back and tell your offensive coordinator, I'd like to keep carrying it, thank you.
To throw on second down, Rose. Open man right side is Smith-Schuster, complete. And he's going to have another first down as the tackle's made here at the Bears' 15-yard line. Looking to throw, Rose. And he just throws this one away. Smart decision here this close to the end zone, and it brings up second down.
So many times we've seen him try to escape the pocket and do something with his legs, but in this case, the pressure was too intense, and he made the wise choice to just get rid of the football and make sure no one was going to get it.
And second and 10, he'll look to throw again. And he's taken down at the 7 after a gain of 7. And just in general, Charles, on a play like that, how tough is it for the defense to account for a running back essentially being a receiver downfield?
It's very difficult, especially if the running back has skills like a receiver, and you're aware of that before the game even begins. So throughout your practice sessions, you're going
to... And he's in! Touchdown, Steelers! Their mobile, agile quarterback. His second touchdown of the game, giving him 12 on the season. And the Steelers are going to retake the lead.
Well, I'd have to say that for him, that was an all-encompassing drive because it was his arm that got his team down to that point, but his legs that finished the deal. Give him credit for making it happen.
Now Mike Tomlin says, let's go ahead and go for 2. They'll look to throw. flushed out right. And he will get into the end zone to extend the lead by two more. And that was the old QB one-man band play there on the conversion.
And look, let's face it, even quarterbacks who don't have great mobility, in certain situations, they're able to actually take the ball in themselves. Remember way back when Joe Namath against the Giants at the Yale Bowl, right? Remember Joe had all those knee operations, they thought he couldn't run it? No one accounted for him. He practically walked into the end zone.
And he'll just take a seat, and the drive will begin at the 25-yard line. And now Chicago getting ready to go as they take the field. And last time they got 3 points, but it was a chip shot field goal. And when you go to the sideline after a chip shot field goal, maybe the offense not too happy.
It's a balancing act, isn't it? Because you're exactly right. They're none too pleased that they didn't punch it in for 6 points. But they also have to remember, they did put points on the board.
3 points is 3 points.
And in this league, you take points when you can get them. Not easily done.
And they're able to get this one across the 35. Line of scrimmage, the 37 on first and 10. Back to throw. Fields. He finds his man. Complete. That's Rhodes. On second down, Montgomery. And he'll push his way up to about the 44 here. They follow up the gain of 5 by only getting 1 there on second down. From the gun on third down, Fields. And able to connect with Berrios. And he will have the Bears first down as they convert on third and 3 with a nice gain of 7 yards.
And that's one of those where it feels like backyard football in a sense. You say, forget about the route. Just run to the open spot in the middle of the field, and I'll find you. Good throw, good concentration on the catch, and they pick up the first down.
Operating out of Steeler territory now. Here's first and 10 at the 49-yard line. Now Montgomery running right. And down to the 44, 5 yards that time. 5 yards remain on second down. Operating from the gun. Fields. Pressure comes and the Steelers take him down. They get to him for a loss of 4, and it brings up third down on the sack.
But you could almost see his eyes light up defensively. I mean, as a linebacker, that's about as quick as you can get to a quarterback.
So what did your third grade teacher teach you about straight lines, right? As soon as you have those, you take full advantage of them. He found a gap in the offensive line, got to the quarterback, and put him on the deck.
And they'll need the 39 here for a first. This is third down. Looking to throw. Fields. And he'll take it down shy of the 45 at the 46. Now it appears we have a Steeler here slow to get up. We'll check on his status when we get back. Here's Matt Hawk now, as he'll punt it away for the second time. And this will carry out of bounds. Where are they going to spot it now? At about the 18-yard line, it looks like. Getting set to go again as we look at the back, heading onto the field again. And as the numbers show, he really wasn't in the mix at the beginning, but they've got him in the rotation now, and it's proved a good move.
And that's what happens when you're a good player. There's a lot more attention drawn to you, and it's obvious that they had him in their game plan on defense, not letting him get off to a good start, but he's found a way so far here in the second half.
And he's taken down, but able to slip across the 35.
As they began to...